Welcome to my campus life video blog, Neon Asian Music. Anyways, keep us civilized about this one, so you just had to just forgot as well. Anyways, last Friday on the Blaze Newswire on the Blaze Television Network, and so is my radio show, which is, you guessed it, last Friday, and so is last, you guessed it, Saturday's television show on Fox. And I did wrote this on my political life blog last Sunday during the Super Bowl Sunday, and I have no clue whatsoever, which I can cite a little bit later, as far as we're concerned. I know, Tom Brady, yeah, I know. Just overjoyed by the Patriots. But anyways, let's see. Because as I said before, you just remember that that no good for nothing Democratic governor buffoon, Mr. Norham, yes. That's right. And you know why? It pays to be nice to people, because everything else can be civilized about this one. And he's trying to make a stupid, idiotic excuses. It wasn't me. And then he's trying to do the moonwalk. Yeah, Michael Jackson does. But there's only one thing that he forgot. And that is, you guessed it, Governor Northam's, yes, that's right, medical school tried to stop making stupid yearbooks over this grossly offensive photos. And that is so pathetic. You know what I'm saying? That is so darn pathetic. And it looks like, yes, he wasn't the only one inside this controversial photo they published, is it? Well, guess what? This is what happens according to the Washington Post. And it says that the medical school that Virginia Governor, yes, Ralph Northam, attended to stop producing, yeah, several yearbooks several years ago. And why? Because there's all this controversial racial charge photos. You wish, buffoon. Guess what? Eastern, Virginia Medical School Provost Richard Holman says that offensive photos, it says according to TheBlaze.com, says try to run this publication led by the whole decision tries to stop annual yearbooks. And Hoffman, you know, specifically, you guessed it, try to point it out into a 2013 photo of three white students dressed up as Confederate uniforms and posing in front of the Confederate flag. Well, I hate to break this to you, but here's Holman says about this one. And it says, we need to make sure that, you know, they understand as physicians that this is offensive to me. And you know why? Because as well as to future patients, and grossly offensive to minority students and us African-Americans. African-Americans, do we all know that? Anyways, because everybody knows he told McBib the Gamita. You know, that's right, his VP, yes, Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion at the same time. And he kept on going, this is what he says. He says, they're going to take care of everybody. You can't be wearing in Senate diary symbols. If you're going to be a young physician and a healer, well, didn't you solve this whole problem? Did you solve this problem? Well, guess what? You might think you're so smart about Sherlock Holmes or Magnum PI as far as we're concerned? Well, guess what? Here's the answer of your, here's your answer for this problem solving. Listen to this. Holman's move to the end of this yearbook may have been prevented in any new controversies. And it didn't prepare the school for what in heavens on earth is going on right now. And what, because that's why when everybody knows that because when a sitting governor has been pressured by the resign of, you guessed it, that's right, 1984, 84. And that means it becomes a man in blackface. And another man in a, what? Go on. So here's the retrospective in everybody's era. All right. That's what he told this, according to the Washington Post. And it says that everybody's era about you know darn well, you guessed it. That's right, because everybody has, yeah, going back to their own darn roots of going back to this old school yearbooks. To see what might have been. And here's what he says. I thought because I stopped publication, that would been half enough. That would have been enough. I think in retrospective, I would have an adult review of those. But didn't you know this very well about, you guessed it? Notice about, you know, that the Norheim picture has been rediscovered all along, because you guessed it, EVMS. That's right, EVMS has been figuring out all along into this whole investigation. In my opinion, that the yearbook program just figured this out. Oh, wow! Would you believe this? Why are everybody trying to figure it out? More of this about the yearbooks has been produced. I cannot even imagine what happens next. A list of things. So, here's my observation. Here's my final thought for you. As far as we're concerned, you try to figure this out for yourself. Because everything else keeps us Northam's explanation. And he's just trying to admit it. That it wasn't? Yeah. Me. You keep on saying the same scenario. But you know the moral of my, you know what that means. The moral of my campus life video blog story is this. Don't we all know that we want to be as open and transparent as possible? And we need to be sure that we examine ourselves. Examine yourself. You are so blindsided. And for you, Mr. Northam, you just wishy-washy, haven't you? Anyways, that's my, the campus life video blog story, and I'm sticking to it. You know what I'm saying? Don't go away. Hashtag Omaha Choirs. Only on Facebook at All Saints and 93rd Bottom Street. It's up for grabs next. Go along, Northam. It's just too stupid to know it.